Hello and welcome to marketing91.com. In this video, we are going to cover the topic on intrapreneurship. Before we proceed any further, please do note that we publish 3 videos daily on YouTube. So please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now let's start with the definition of intrapreneurship. A system in organizations or companies where the staff is permitted to perform like entrepreneurs is called intrapreneurship. When companies through entrepreneurship allow their staff to put their entrepreneurial skills to work for their and the company's gain, an enterprising environment is created. Along with providing the employees a chance to grow in the company, it also enables them to experiment. Intrapreneurship fosters autonomy and independence while attempting to find the best possible solution. Endorsing intrapreneurship can reap high benefits for employers since a department or company succeeds collectively. Development and change are inspired when the employees are retained. Moving on to who is an intrapreneur. The energetic, ambitious, and pragmatic staff of a company who take the initiative to go after the original services or products are called intrapreneurs. Moving forward, how to inculcate an intrapreneurship culture? First, independence and adaptability. Most of the time, employees do not get time to devise new ideas and pitch them to the management because they are overworked by companies. Employers must ensure that the staff has sufficient time to devise and work with new concepts. Next, supporting and enabling people. Motivate original and innovative thinking even if they end up failing. Their fear of failure itself might discourage original ideas that the staff might want to convey. Next, hire employees with the correct mindset. Innovative, entrepreneurial spirited, and street smart people must be recruited. Devise ways that will encourage them to convey their ideas to management. Next, development culture. Build an internal scheme or developmental center that recognizes and encourages exceptional employees with respect to modern and creative projects for the company. Such a development center should be headed by a top management member. Next, appreciate and reward. The most successful way to instill intrapreneurial skills among the staff is to connect rewards and appraisals with innovative and productive ideas. And finally, provide guidance. Due to insufficient experience and knowledge of employees, many amazing ideas are not shared by them. Appropriate training from seniors can aid the staff to share their ideas with the management clearly. Moving on to benefits of having an intrapreneurship culture. It is important for long-lived sustainability. Smoothly running business areas can improve the profits earned by the organization. Captivating and keeping the most entrepreneurial and innovative staff of the company. Newly developed creative projects can generate new income flows, increases participation and cooperation within the company, and preparing your company to be more nimble, energetic, and equipped for change. According to Deloitte, 88% of Fortune 500 companies in 1955 are no longer present in 2015. Quite shocking. To understand what needs to happen, make sure you're around in for 5 to 10 years of the company. You can draw inspiration from highly innovative companies and observe what they're doing. Moving on to intrapreneurship examples. First, Skunkworks. Skunkworks Group at Lockheed Martin is the most infamous example of intrapreneurship. The name of the group was inspired by a cartoon reference. It was founded in 1943 to construct the fighter jet P-80. The proposal was internally classified and secured since it was to be a component of the war effort. Because the project was to eventually become a part of the war effort, the project was internally protected and secretive. The director of this group was Kelly Johnson, who later gained fame for Kelly's 14 rules of intrapreneurship. Next, Paul Boucher. He was the creator of Gmail and was a computer engineer from America. After working for Intel, Boucher was the 23rd employee hired by Google. In 2001, he started working on Gmail while being employed at Google with the help of his revolution in storage and search. He also developed the original model of Google AdSense while working on Gmail. Next in line, Krishna Bharat. Google News was a byproduct of the attacks of September 11, 2001. It was created by Krishna Bharat to keep himself up to date about the developments. It has been a well-liked contribution from Google since then. It was one of the first ventures of Google to provide more than plain text searches. Next, Ken Kutargi. The junior engineer at Sony, Ken, played around with his daughter's gaming consoles in the late 80s and came up with a superior product. It is not a known fact that since more people are unaware of the gaming industry's future, top management at Sony resisted the PlayStation. Various people believed it to be a trend that would die down. But Noriyoga, the group CEO, encouraged the product. After launching in 1994 for the first time, PlayStation faced massive sales. Sony Computer Entertainment was the name of the subsidiary found after that. After being appointed the CEO of this company, he was appointed as a group CEO and chairman. Moving on to the risk entrepreneurship. Identifying these employees is vital for employers. Failing to identify employees who show entrepreneurial skills or discouraging entrepreneurship can be harmful to a company or brand. Entrepreneurs who are not encouraged in a particular company might turn to work in other companies or start something of their own. And finally, the differentiation between entrepreneurship and entrepreneurship. Let's start with a description. Entrepreneurship inside an organization is called entrepreneurship, whereas the active process of generating gradual wealth is called entrepreneurship. Chief purpose for entrepreneurship is to intensify the freedom and remuneration capacity of the company. For entrepreneurship, independence, creative development, and financial benefits. For entrepreneurship, the threat endures average risk, whereas in entrepreneurship, endures risk of all kinds. The position, independence is expected by employees in a company, whereas on the other hand, self-governing and already independent individuals do not care about status. Errors and defeat, since they are immensely scared of failure, new projects are classified unless ready. On the other hand, they try to identify and understand failures to help their creative development efforts. Pursuit, employees participate directly and it is beyond just representing the authority. On the other hand, parties are involved directly and completely in the creative development process. Moving further, whom they help? They serve themselves and the company. On the other hand, they serve customers. Time limits. In entrepreneurship, there are time limits set by the company or by themselves. On the other hand, they do not work on the basis of time limits. How about association with others? In entrepreneurship, the relationships are outlined by authority structures. On the other hand, their relationships are based on communications and negotiations. Center of attention. In entrepreneurship, they concentrate on the market and the technology. On the other hand, they concentrate on sustaining competition and sales. And finally, the functioning. In entrepreneurship, they function from inside the company. Entrepreneurship, they function from outside the company. So that's it, folks. This brings an end to the topic on entrepreneurship. These are some of the sources and links referred to for the content in the video. If you have liked the video, do subscribe to our channel where you'll witness 3 new videos daily. Additionally, if you want to view these videos in an organized manner, you can visit freecourses.net where all our videos are arranged in the form of courses. Thank you and see you in the next video.